Hello friends, welcome to a new video of Let's Watercolor with Vanidas. In this series of videos, I will take you through my way of doing watercolors. My objective is that jointly we make the watercolor painting a fun-filled and very dynamic activity. Hope we will enjoy.
Today we are going to make a water and reflection scene. It's a very simple scene, so we will try to crop certain part of it. We'll avoid this much portion, and whatever we are seeing, we'll take only that much portion, so that this matches with the paper that we are using. So often you may have to kind of crop your reference image to fit into the aspect ratio of your paper. We'll quickly make a sketch. We are reducing the level of water little down. It's almost half, but slightly below. We'll make the boat surface almost this area, so that we have a space for showing the reflections and all. Basically, this is a kind of a thumbnail that we are making. So, kind of designing or planning the work. So our boat will be up to here. So somewhere up to here we will make the platform, whatever you see. Don't try to be precise here. We may have to alter this. And this is kind of a boat house, so you will have a roof and some structures. So I'm kind of making the roof and some of the structures here. It has some interesting structure here, so it is not like a conventional boat. I'm not going for very precise drawing here, because as you can see in the reference, it is fully on the shadow. This particular boat is fully under the shadow. The light is coming from the other side, so it is kind of a silhouette type of drawing, so you don't have to really worry about a lot of things. Everything is in shadow. Some flag here, whether we will paint it or not, and we have some sort of pole here which will help in getting the reflections better. So we'll have the reflections of the platform here. Okay. And we'll also have the reflections of the boat here. Now we will have some distant distant land here. Right, and here also we'll have some kind of fine reflections. Okay. Wherever there is some opportunity to show reflections, let us take those elements so that the water will appear to be more realistic. Maybe I am adding another element here, some kind of a wooden step. Okay. It is just, the purpose is just to show some reflection so that the water will become much more realistic. Now here we have some cloudy sky. As you can see in the reference, there are some cloudy sky. Okay. I think it is better we add some more elements to cover this part of the sky. So what I am assuming is that somewhere outside of the frame, there are some trees coming here, tree branches. From my side, it serves two purposes. One is it covers this kind of a blank area, and it helps in getting the viewer's eye to the point of interest, which is somewhere here. I think this is a reasonably simple and good subject. So we'll get into the painting process, but before painting, we'll quickly indicate the positions of the elements in the watercolor paper. In the watercolor paper, we will not do all these shadings and all those things. Maybe we will just make certain key landmarks. So today's work we are doing in a quarter sheet of paper. I'm using an Indian handmade paper called Maestriaa, 300 GSM rough texture. And we'll make the quick drawing. So here we'll have this is the level of water, right? It is slightly below the half, and we'll have some distant foliages here. It is important that this line is straight because it is the top edge of water body, so that should be straight. We'll have a boat somewhere here. The bottom edge of the boat, and it's a typical, carved boat, so I'm trying to be little precise at this part. See, rest everything is very silhouette type, because this boat is at, the light is coming from the other side, so most of the structures are falling on the shadow. So I think this much is sufficient here. because the exactly where the pole comes and all those things we will do once during the painting stage. I mean, that gives us a little bit more freedom. I mean, depending upon where the reflections are more appropriate, I will shift the pole and all. So I'm not drawing it there. And even the trees and the tree foliages which is coming from the top, that also I will leave it now, because depending upon how good the sky and the clouds are there, we will modify this. I think this much is sufficient for now. I'll just indicate only the key reflection, the kind of the reflection should stop here for the bot. That is the only indication. Rest everything is fine. So there are a couple of characters we will put here, but those things we will do once the rest of the things are done, right? So we'll have to go for the washes. We have the drawing now. Now we'll go for the washes. I'll be using cobalt blue, little bit ultramarine blue. This is cerulean blue. I have a violet here. I have a burnt umber, burnt sienna. I have orange and red, vermilion red and orange. This is Indian yellow. And I have sap green and olive green, right? So these are the colors I might use. There are more colors in the palette, but I may not use others. In case I use any other color, I will let you know. For the washes, I am using some mop brushes. So I am using some number 6 mop brush for the main washes. For the smaller washes, I will use a smaller mop brush. You could use any round brush. For the skies, I will be using very very pale stuff, very pale cobalt blue. Maybe a little touch of violet. And burnt sienna. It is very pale. It is a kind of a dull color. Basically, we are filling the sky. We are leaving this area. I'm using a lot of water, making this little bit a warmer tone at the distance. This water. Now making it cooler. Some darker and the, when it comes to the bottom. So it's a very very quick wash. Now I think it is worth making some cloudy touches on this. So what we'll make is we'll mix some cloudy tone, some burnt sienna, maybe some violet, same color, little darker. That's it. Whatever we used earlier, the same thing but little darker. So we'll make some touches. Not very precise. I think that went too dark. Some touches here and there. See, we are just making some brush marks, so once it gets dry, I think we are hoping that things will all be good. We'll have to wait until this dries. I think it is dry. You can just have a feel if it is dry with the back of your hand. So we'll make the next layer. The next thing what I wanted to make is, I want to make a small distant foliages here. So we'll try to make that foliages, and then I will kind of make this area a little bit more darker. It dried a lot duller. We'll make it a little darker. I am just wetting some of the portion here. Clean your brush. I mean, my brush was not clean enough. Clean your brush and wet some portion. Just water. Okay. The objective is that the edges are little not very sharp edges. We want is very soft edges. So if you apply water, some amount of spread will happen and you get a soft edge. So basically, so the bottom edge should be little straight line-ish. I'm trying to be little precise when it reaches to the bottom edge. I'm leaving some white spots so that you can assume those things as some distant structures kind of thing. I think that is sufficient. Just maybe like just I'm touching here, just maybe to indicate some little bit of reflection sort of thing, just touching. Not too much. What I'm trying to do is, I want to get some more darker tones towards the bottom, so kind of doing that, and I'm kind of making with the tip of the brush. I'm trying to make define some kind of waves or something of that sort. With the almost a watery brush, very minor slight tones. Yeah. The objective is to bring some depth as well as some kind of a wavy wavy tones, wavy strokes, that's it. Now this area is done. This area is still wet. Probably we can do some touches on the boat, because this area is somewhat dry, so we will make the boat. Here, if you remember, it was kind of orangish. Here it was little orangish touch at the roof, so we will make that first. This kind of a tone is very soft tones, very dull colors, so we will not use very bright colors for this. We will again we'll take little bit of orange, but we will try to kind of dull it. I'm making it little duller so that there is a kind of harmony in terms of the colors that we are using. You have to be little careful when you reach the edges. Maybe I would suggest using a smaller brush for this. I'm not really worried about the lower edge, because we will be applying darker tones on top of this, so that should be fine. I'm only worried mainly about the top edge. It should be a little precise. Some of the platform also I'm kind of defining the color. We'll be working little bit more details here. Now we'll have to work with the further details of the boat, but I would prefer waiting it till this area gets little bit dry, because while working here, if you touch this wet area, your dark tones might spread here and it might create unwanted effects. So let us wait until this gets dry. We are going to make some details around this area and the boat. We are taking a little bit of again burnt sienna, and this time I am using a little bit of ultramarine blue rather than cobalt blue. I am taking a smaller brush now, because we need a little bit more precision. I thought it is dry, but it is not fully. We will have to wait some more time. This area is still a little bit of wet. You don't have to map exactly what is there in the reference. You can work your own way, no, not a problem. So these things are just need not to be very precise stuff. It is some darker tone that I am trying to make, that's it. Making this side little softer, just applying some water. Yes, we don't need a very uniform tones. I don't want very precise edges and all. We will make this structure with a little bit more precision. We'll use little, again the same burnt sienna, maybe a little bit of cobalt blue or any blue basically. I tend to mix various colors depending upon what is there in the palette. At this edge it is, let us be a little precise. I'm varying the tone slightly with a little brownish tone. I'm adding some little bit brownish tone just to have some kind of a variation. Now here you remember we have drawn the platforms, so we should be a little careful. At this portion we had the platform. Now I think we have done a bit of details on the boat. We'll have to do something on this platform. Now we are doing something on this platform, kind of creating some edges, creating some softness. Okay, let us wait until this gets a little dry. This seems to be very, very uniform. Just breaking it a little bit by sprinkling some water. Now we'll have to go for the reflections. Basically, it will be kind of a mirror reflection of this particular object here, but it will not be very with the precise edges, so you'll have to consider the form of water waves. So basically I'm trying to define, I'm trying to follow this edge, plus also trying to consider the waveforms. Taking slightly bigger brush, trying to be little. Now we have to make the reflection for this also. Now this has a top and edge here. It it is very easy to get it overdone, so let us not go for that. Okay, I think we'll stop it there. Once we do the other step, maybe we'll give some final touches. If you remember, there was some flag sort of thing, so let us make that flag here. Okay, so that will have also, that also will have some reflection. That seems to be too dark for me, so I'm just immediately hitting it, the color. Now we'll go for a little bit more details. See, you don't have to really do exactly what is there in the reference, because the reference is just to be used as a kind of, you can use the reference just as a guideline, unless you are making very realistic painting. Using very realistic work, then of course the reference is very important. But in our case, that is just for, you can take that as for inspiration. Just touching with some brown, just to have some variation. I think it has gone to plain colors. Let it bleed. We have made some tones here. I think some more waveform definition will be helpful. I'm taking a medium sized brush and again making the water mix, that is burnt sienna, violet and blue, and maybe I'm adding little bit more definition of water. Bigger brush. Now we'll make some trees here. By the time I'm expecting this to be dry, and we'll give some final touches, finishing touches. So we are adding some tree foliages, which is not in the reference. So that is, the idea is just to get some kind of interest creation. That's it. These are the foliage edges. We are just defining the edges and then going with the larger volumes. If you want, you can draw it. I am not drawing it because I want little bit of randomness. I am just using the, most of the time I am using the belly of the brush. The main thing is try to get some volume and some randomness. You don't need to be precise. we'll connect them using some branches. To create the branches, you can use some liner brush. I am using a liner brush. By liner brush, what I mean is any brush with a long tip, a narrow brush with a long tip and a good point. I think that's enough for that. Here again, we are trying to define some branches. You don't have to be very precise here. Basically, connect the foliages somehow. Basically, it is a kind of connecting these volumes. That's it. Again, don't overdo. I'm deliberately making some hanging branches here. That is just to create some interest. Defining this particular thing, it went dull little bit. Now I think we need little bit of emphasizing touches. These are some random touches which I feel will improve our work. So may not be very, there is no specific rules for this. Just I'm adding little bit of reflection sort of thing for this. For this also. Now we need a little bit more definition here, but since this area is still wet, we'll wait until this area is little dry. Now it is not fully dry but mostly dry, so I think we can proceed further. So we'll have some details here. We need to do quite a bit of touch-ups here, and then we will add some more elements somewhere here so that it looks a little bit of balance. It has become too much of dull. We will make a little bit of orangish touch there. Some of this will get it will go a little dull once it dries. Right.
Now,
I think it is better to add some sort of character here. These are all just kind of suggestive. If you remember, there was some structure here. So this area looks too much blank, so let us add something here so that there is some kind of a balance. Some wooden stuff, okay, you just want to break the blankness here. This also may have can I have a little bit of a reflection. These are some opportunity to create some reflections. Okay. Now we'll add some characters here also. I'm just. No, this is a dark area. The lights are not really falling here, but still I think we will create some character here to have some interest. I'm mixing a little bit of white here so that since it is little dark area, I'm adding little a touch of white to make it visible. think we are pretty much done. Maybe if you want, you can make another small boat here. Just make some kind of a small boat, a normal boat here. And a small reflection for this. I have added a touch of white here. See, there could be argument that we should not use white at all, but I feel it is okay to have some white touches to accentuate the things. We will have some white touches to define the characters also. Some white touches. I think we are done. So I'll just add my signature. Now we'll take out the tape. Thanks very much for watching this. We have covered all the aspects from the planning, drawing, washes, and even the giving the details. Hope you enjoyed it.
That's it for today. Hope you were with me throughout this video. If you have any comments, suggestions, questions, please do mention them in the comment section below. If you like my video, please click on the thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I will strive to produce more videos with your support and motivation by addressing all your comments and suggestions, and I will also try to respond to your questions, suggestions as frequently as possible. Hope we'll meet you in the next video, and we'll continue with the fun of painting watercolors. Thank you very much.